Now, Kanu youth wingers were feared for their ruthless brutality, but there was no fear when thugs attacked five Kanu youth wingers in 1988. The attack near Dandora dump site left three people dead and two others fighting for their lives. KTN's Timothy Otieno traced the families of the two remaining survivors and filed the following report.
December 1988 at Dandora dump site, five Kanu youth wingers were scouting the area, a daily routine that on that night would change their lives forever. A quick ambush and a small crossfire between the youths and an unknown group left five people bleeding and fighting to stay alive. One of them is 55-year-old John Njoroge. He had spotted a group lurking near the dump site and decided to investigate.
Katuuliza nyinyi kina nani? Sisi tukamwambia sisi ni Kanu youth winger. Na wakatujibu nyinyi ndio mnakataza sisi tufanye kazi yetu. Hakuna lingine ni kufyatua risasi.
Njoroge was shot twice. Four of his workmates got three gunshots each.
Simama ishi. Ishi mwenye risasi. Iliingia sasa ikaje ikakaa nini? Ikakaa kwa kifua. Ambayo nilifanyia upasuaji katika Kenyatta.
A bullet fractured his right arm and in the process dislocated the joint, forcing him to accommodate a metal plate connected with seven screws at the joint. But Njoroge was lucky to escape with his life. Three of his colleagues died that night, and the only other person who survived the ordeal, Joseph Kamau, passed away last year. His 34-year-old daughter Helen is left with pictures of her father's burial that she now cherishes as her source of solace.
Venye tu maisha yake ilianza kuharibika tu on the spot venye alipata that accident. So unaona maisha yetu ikakuwa ni ile mnabahatisha kukula, mnabahatisha nini. Unaona mpaka wasai hata hivyo ndio tu tunang'ang'ana juu sasa utashindwa ufanye.
Helen says her father died with a bullet still lodged in his arm 25 years later.
Hiyo serikali ya kitambo mimi naweza nikasema yai kutujali tu kama ilimjali pia sisi watu tungetaka kusoma tukoe na majobu zetu. Sasa unaona hatukuweza hivyo.
The Kanu Youth Wingers was an initiative by the then government to engage the youth productively in supporting the police in maintaining law and order.
Mtoto wako aenda kununulia sukari. Ukimpea shilingi moja ama saa zingine hata ukiwa ni wewe mwanaume na unatembea na bibi yako, unapigwa na bibi yako anashukuliwa hapo. Kulikuwa na ugaidi mkali.
Tegemea jirani hapa. Na kweli tumesaidia sababu tuko na upendo. Hata kama tungekuwa na hiyo pesa, tungekuwa tu kama tumesalipa.
Njoroge feels that Kanu neglected them after the incident.
And there's no record in the office to show me that even which was transferred and carried over. But I can vouch for the fact that we never had a security force called Youth Wing.
He blames his poor health for his loneliness. His wife took their six children with them when she left in 2011. This wooden structure is all John Njoroge has left 25 years after that fateful incident that left him physically handicapped. He says over the years life has been of struggle, regret and much pain, and he hopes that the new year will come with better results, at least health-wise. Timothy Otieno, KTN.